Before we get to the book signing, if people have any questions for either the professor or our author, please ask them now. I think the room is short, it's small enough that we don't keep the mic. Which is that, if you have, for writing, one can have any number of reasons. But for writing this particular book, what was that one driver that led you to start and then complete the book?
Thank you, of course, to Professor for very nicely introducing the book to us. One, of course, the main reason that sustained me was my own fascination and bhakti towards Ram, actually. Without that, the book wouldn't have moved. See, looking at it from both angles, whether for Rama or against Rama, it was essentially the devotion towards him made it possible, I must say that. And then, at another level, it was also about the concern always that if somebody is not allowed to express themselves, what will happen to them? That could be as a child, you're not allowed to express your opinions as an individual. What happens to you? And what form it takes, that suppression and repression, how it manifests. So that also was very, that drove me. Because I used to always think to myself, like, if I'm not allowed to say this, or I'm not allowed to speak this, or voice this, how will I feel? How will I react in the world? That got me moving at each page. Because if you see the novel, it's like a cat and mouse game. They are both, battling each other in a very ordinary people. But even then, they are battling. So that's what it is.
Bouncing on such a light topic.
That's true. But of course, I think even in India, if you're critical or if people perceive that you're targeting A community or B community, that's when people get upset. If you criticize largely, people don't come after you. Most people are, I think, in India pretty decent. If they perceive that you are deliberately targeting their community, whether any community it is, then that's when people get upset. And in that sense, in the novel, there's nobody who's, even the atheists are, they just are angry, but they're not saying nasty things about anybody. So I'm assuming that I'm in safe ground. So, but of course, there's nothing offensive. Nobody says anything offensive to anyone. Yeah,
yeah.
Say goodbye and please read it also.
So in this story, the mother is the atheist and the son is the religious person. So religious is not common. Normally, you see the mother is the religious and the child who probably goes away from religion. So did you, is that based on being real characters that you know? Or the author of religion?
Actually, no, it's not based on any real character, because even in real life, I see mothers are more religious than children. But why I chose the mother as the atheist is because in every family, the parent represents power. The child is the, in a way, they are not powerful. And so the mother can set the agenda, and here she is setting the agenda. And in this case, the atheism to me is just one thing. I mean, it's an aspect, but the bigger issue is not allowing somebody to express themselves, which a parent can do. It could be a simple thing, not allowing you to paint, not allowing you to sing. In this case, it's religion. So that's why the mother is the atheist.
Just one more related question. So, Govinda, who is supposed to be not very intelligent and some innocent character, you chose him to be the religious person. So, is there anything more to read there, or is it just part of the bigger story?
Yeah, because, today if you see, because we all grow up in the, as Professor said, the story of a woman getting kidnapped and the story of a woman getting disrobed. That's what our religious books have. We're growing up in a very a-religious way, in a way. So, and or else we think that people who are religious are either very fanatical or they're superstitious people. That's why they're coming to God. But here this boy is neither superstitious and nor is he ambitious. He's just curious, and as an innocent, that innocence is to only show that he doesn't have any agenda. That's why he's almost a very naive kind of a person. Somebody told me that the hero is like an idiot. But I don't know whether that was a positive thing or a negative thing, but he's a very ordinary. And essentially to show the innocence, that religious people are not, some thugs or something.
He doesn't believe in all those things. But his child, 4 years, 5 years, always towards God. What is your conscience? Similar, like mother is there and is happy. What do you say about that? He is trying to convert the child to LFTs. But the child is 5 years, but talks off all of religion and all those things. So much she talks. What do you say about this?
That's not new, because remember Prahalada, how he grew up. So for all of us, we know, because each one of us comes with our own karmic baggage. So who is parent? Parents are only parents, they're not gods, So each child comes with its own destiny. And this is a good example of that.
There are two big conflicts in the book. One is Vaidehi and the god, and the other is Kodanda and Vaidehi. So, are these conflicts symbolic of something bigger, or something in the society that you see?
Definitely, because what is happening to Kodanda and his mother at the level of individuals and family can happen at a social level also. See, whole communities' histories can be just not wiped out, but I don't want to use a very dramatic word. Out of indifference, people may not know. You may just not even be allowed to express yourself. So what is happening to Kodanda can happen to several people, like what we call tyranny of distance, and we can have tyranny of bad memory. So it is happening. I mean, it's both at this personal level and at a social level. In fact, even the friendlessness of Rama, which is, at one level it is just, it's a very innocent remark by a Bhagavatar, a singer. And very innocently the boy latches on to it and he wants to see, befriend Rama. But later the book asks the question, does Rama really have friends, When Ram Lala sits under the tent, is the question. Does he really have friends? So it's parallel. It's not that this is more important than that is less important. They're both equally important, but those questions are all the time being proved. So they are working at the
level. One is about, were there any Indian books that inspired you to write this? And the second question is, have you read the Ramayana in original? And these are the two questions.
I only read Rajaji's Ramayana, and later I read Kamala Subramanian's Ramayana. She has that. I started reading, I'm trying to read the Valmiki's Ramayana, the Gorakhpur Press 2 volumes. Very slowly I do the Maratha. So I haven't read it in its original, I've only read the Kamala Subramanian version. And as for the first question, sir, what is the first question? Yeah.
Was there any specific book you felt any
idea? Oh, okay. Actually, not particularly any book. But many authors, when I was in the 90s, for example, Amitabh Ghosh or John Steinbeck, or now, of course, in recent times, Bhairappa, these are people who have influenced me. I mean, their way of writing, the way they express themselves, and the ideas that they want to talk about. So these have influenced this little boy at the back.
Why do you say that God is famous? Because all of us who worship Lama, we all are also
friends, so what do you say? Yes. Thank you. We are all worshipping Rama. This question was that why you say Ram is friendless, because we are all worshipping him. Yes. Actually, it starts, Bhagavata is, there's a form of Carnatic music, just as background, where it's called Ninda Stuti, when you make fun of God and praise him. It's a very unique to Carnatic music. The Bhagavatar is using this friendlessness in that context. He just says, you're a great husband, you're a fantastic son, you are a great warrior, but listen, you don't have any friends. Because friends imply equality. Friends imply naughtiness, having fun together. And the truth is that in Rama's life, there's really no fun, because he's always upholding dharma. So in that sense, that friendlessness is related to that. Because only when you can have a lot of fun with your friends. You can't, those who are friendless are people who are very serious or they're upholding something, and definitely they don't have friends. And of course there's a larger question, which is the, Ram Lalla under the tent. Why is he really friendless? Is he friendless?